ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। हरे कृष्ण। आई वेलकम एवरीवन फॉर दिस लास्ट सेशन ऑफ अवर 30-day Gita Jayanti series. So in this 1 month we have covered over 35 shlokas of Bhagavad Gita so far. Today we will take the last shloka of Bhagavad Gita. Yesterday we have seen the last shloka in terms of concluding shloka of the conversation between Krishna and Arjuna. Now we will see the concluding shloka in the conversation between धृतराष्ट्रे एंड संजय. ओके सो यत्र योगेश्वरः कृष्णो यत्र पार्थो धनुर्धरः तत्र श्रीर्विजयो भूतेर ध्रुवा नीतिर्मतिर्मम. परीक्षित फर्स्ट लाइन. यत्र योगेश्वरः कृष्णो
यत्र योगेश्वरः
परीक्षित्र
पार्थो धनुर्धरः यत्र योगेश्वर कृष्ण यत्र योगेश्वर कृष्ण यत्र योगेश्वर कृष्ण यत्र योगेश्वर कृष्ण.
ओके थैंक यू. स्मृति. यत्र पार्थो धनुर्धरः
यत्र पार्थो धनुर्धरः यत्र पार्थो धनुर्धरः यत्र पार्थो धनुर्धरः यत्र पार्थो धनुर्धरः. हरे कृष्ण.
गरिमा. तत्र श्रीर्विजयो भूतेर
तत्र श्रीर्विजयो भूतेर तत्र श्रीर्विजयो भूतेर तत्र श्रीर्विजयो भूतेर तत्र श्रीर्विजयो भूतेर तत्र श्रीर्विजयो भूतेर.
ध्रुवा नीतिर्मतिर्मम
ध्रुवा नीतिर्मतिर्मम ध्रुवा नीतिर्मतिर्मम
यत्र योगेश्वर कृष्णो यत्र पार्थो धनुर्धर यत्र योगेश्वर कृष्णो यत्र पार्थो धनुर्धर यत्र योगेश्वर कृष्णो यत्र पार्थो धनुर्धर.
मयि तत्र श्रीर्विजयो भूते ध्रुवानि तिर्मतिर्मम
तत्र श्रीर्विजयो भूतेर ध्रुवानि तिर्मतिर्मम तत्र श्रीर्विजयो भूतेर ध्रुवानि तिर्मतिर्मम तत्र श्रीर्विजयो भूतेर ध्रुवानि तिर्मतिर्मम.
थैंक यू. नेक्स्ट मधुलता माताजी फुल श्लोक. यत्र योगेश्वरः कृष्णो
यत्र योगेश्वरः कृष्णो यत्र पार्थो धनुर्धरः यत्र योगेश्वरः कृष्णो यत्र पार्थो धनुर्धरः यत्र योगेश्वरः कृष्णो यत्र पार्थो धनुर्धरः.
ज्योति ज्योतिश्रेया यू कैन रिसाइट. यत्र योगेश्वरः कृष्णो
यत्र योगेश्वरः कृष्णो
यत्र पार्थो धनुर्धरः
यत्र पातो धनुर्धरः
तत्र श्रीर्विजयो भूतेर
तत्र श्रीविजयो भूतेर
ध्रुवानि तिर्मतिर्मम
ध्रुवानि तिर्मतिर्मम.
थैंक यू. सुहृद.
यत्र योगेश्वरो कृष्णो यत्र पार्थो धनुर्धरः तत्र श्रीर्विजयो भूतेर ध्रुवानि तिर्मतिर्मम.
हरे कृष्ण प्रभुजी. कैन आई रिसाइट आफ्टर यू.
यत्र योगेश्वरः कृष्णो
यत्र योगेश्वरः कृष्णो
यत्र पार्थो धनुर्धरः
यत्र पार्थो धनुर्धरः
तत्र श्रीर्विजयो भूतेर
तत्र श्रीर्विजयो भूतेर
ध्रुवानि तिर्मतिर्मम
ध्रुवानि मतिर्मम.
ऋषिकेश.
यस प्रभु. यत्र योगेश्वरः कृष्णो यत्र पार्थो धनुर्धरः तत्र श्रीर्विजयो भूतिर्ध्रुवनीतिर्मतिर्मम
यत्र योगेश्वर कृष्ण यत्र पार्थो धनुर्धर तत्र श्रीविजयो भूतिर्ध्रुवनीतिर्मतिर्मम
विद्या माताजी यत्र योगेश्वरः कृष्णो
यत्र योगेश्वरो कृष्णो
यत्र पार्थो धनुर्धरः
यत्र पार्थो धनुर्धरः
तत्र श्रीर्विजयो भूतेर्
तत्र श्रीविजयो भूतेर्
ध्रुवनीतिर्मतिर्मम
ध्रुवनीतिर्मतिर्मम हरे कृष्ण प्रभुजे.
Now we will discuss the meaning of this beautiful concluding shloka of Bhagavad Gita. In this shloka, Sanjaya is speaking to Dhritarashtra. He says, Yatra Yogeshwaraha Krishna, Yatra means wherever there is. Yogeshwaraha Krishna, Krishna is Yogeshwara, means Yogeshwara means the master of all mystics. So wherever there is Krishna, who is the master of all mystics, and Yatra, wherever there is Partha, Arjuna, who is Dhanurdhara, the great bowman who holds bow. So wherever there is Krishna and wherever there is Arjuna, there shall be, means Tatra, what will be there? Shri, prosperity or opulence. Victory, Vijaya. Bhutir means extraordinary power. Dhruva, Nitir, certainly there will be morality also. Matir Mama, this is my opinion, this is my conviction, Sanjaya says. So wherever there is Krishna and wherever there is Arjuna, there will be prosperity, victory, power and morality. And this is the conviction of Sanjaya. So this is the meaning of this shloka. The meaning is clear. So right in the first shloka of Bhagavad Gita, we see Dhritarashtra asked Sanjaya, my dear Sanjaya, after my sons and the sons of Pandu have assembled on the battlefield of Kurukshetra, what did they do? So, and he explained the whole Bhagavad Gita. Then finally, Sanjaya is concluding his narration of Bhagavad Gita with this shloka. He says that, my dear Dhritarashtra, don't have any hopes that your sons headed by Duryodhana will be victorious. Wherever there is Krishna and wherever there is Arjuna, wherever this wonderful combination of Krishna and Arjuna is there, there will be prosperity and victory. This is my conviction. I'm fully convinced about it. So there will be no victory for your sons, although they are sided by Bhishma, Drona, Karna, many other people. Because wherever Krishna is there, there will be victory. So Krishna is the supreme personality of Godhead. And wherever Krishna is there, his eternal consort Lakshmi also will be there. So wherever Lakshmi and Narayana both are personally present, so there will be victory to that side. So Pandavas will be victorious, not your sons. So he clarified. So now you see, what is the real victory here? So Bhagavad Gita is ending with a very, very happy note. So the real victory is to be determined to serve Krishna. Karishye vachanam tava. Just before this shloka, just few verses before, Arjuna told Krishna that nashto mohaha smritir labdha tat prasadan mayachita. Sthitotme gata sandeha karishye vachanam tava. So here he said, or Arjuna said, my dear Krishna, all my doubts are gone. I got clarity in life. So karishye vachanam tava. I agree to follow your instructions. I agree to fight in this war according to your expectations. Karishye vachanam tava means I am going to follow your instructions. So a real victory is to be determined to serve Krishna and follow the instructions of Krishna. Even Bhagavatam also says, yasya anuvrittya kritino bhuvima. Anuvrittya. When we follow the instructions of Krishna, there will be success, there will be victory. Our success is to be determined to execute the instructions of Krishna. That's how the Gita is ending. So initially Arjuna said that I have so many confusions in my mind. I'm dharma sammodha chetaha. I'm confused about my duty. But the end of Bhagavad Gita, Arjuna said, that now all my doubts are gone, all my confusions are gone. So with a clear mindset, I am going to execute your instruction. So in the beginning of Gita, Arjuna accepted Krishna's shelter in a state of helplessness, in a state of confusion. But at the end of Bhagavad Gita, Arjuna surrendered to Krishna by showing his readiness to execute his will, to execute his instruction. So Bhagavad Gita brought Arjuna from a state of helplessness to a state of readiness. So Arjuna took shelter of Krishna in a state of helplessness in the beginning of Bhagavad Gita. Now Arjuna is taking shelter of Krishna in a state of readiness to execute his instructions. Okay, Krishna, you wanted to establish dharma by killing the representatives of adharma, who are this Duryodhana party. So I'm going to assist you. I will assist you in establishing dharma. That is my dharma. Okay. Krishna said, Sarva dharman parityajya mamaikam sharanam raja. Take my shelter. Give up all the other duties that you have concocted. So Arjuna agreed to do this. So Bhagavad Gita brings clarity in confused minds, and Bhagavad Gita makes one approach Krishna with a readiness to execute his instruction rather than in a helpless state, right? So there are two conversations that are happening in Bhagavad Gita. One conversation is between Arjuna and Krishna. Another conversation is between Sanjaya and Dhritarashtra. It was Sanjaya who was narrating Bhagavad Gita to Dhritarashtra. So that Sanjaya is speaking. And Sanjaya is quoting the conversation that happened between Krishna and Arjuna on the battlefield of Kurukshetra. So now there are two conclusions. There are two conversations and there are two conclusions. But both conclusions are same only. So how did the conversation between Krishna and Arjuna end? Yesterday we spoke. Krishna conclusively said, Sarva dharman parityajya mamaikam sharanam raja aham tvam sarva pape bhyo mokshayishyami mashachah. So Krishna said, my dear Arjuna, I will relieve you from all sinful reactions. You forget all other dharmas and just surrender to this ultimate dharma of taking my shelter, following my instructions. And Arjuna confirmed it. Yes, my dear Lord, I am going to surrender unto you. I am going to act according to your will. Tanishye vachanam tava. That's how the conversation between Krishna and Arjuna ended. So now, what did Sanjaya say? So Sanjaya is concluding his conversation by saying that yatra yogeshwarah krishno yatra partho dhanurdharah tatra shri vijayo bhutir dhruva nitir madhira mama. Wherever Arjuna is there and wherever Krishna is there will be victory. So both conclusions are same. So one is loving surrender of a devotee. Second is loving protection offered by Krishna, offered by God. So this is how Gita is concluding. So Arjuna agreed to serve Krishna according to his desire. So here Arjuna's loving surrender is being demonstrated and Krishna's loving protection is being demonstrated. So whenever this combination is there, when the devotee agrees to align with the will of the Lord, when a devotee's desire becomes the desire of the Lord, means the devotee manages to make his desires similar to the desires of the Lord, then that combination of Krishna and his devotee will bring all success and prosperity. That's how our Sanjay is concluding the Bhagavad Gita. Will of a devotee becomes one with the wish of God. That amazing combination causes all prosperity and all victory. So here Arjuna's will became one with the will of Krishna. Earlier Arjuna's desire was different from Krishna's desire. Krishna wanted to establish dharma and kill adharma through Arjuna. But Arjuna said, no, these are my relatives. I cannot fight with my own relatives. But Krishna said, no, please take this instructions of Bhagavad Gita and compose your mind. And finally, Arjuna said, yes, I'm going to fight with my relatives also to establish dharma. So Arjuna's desire at the end of Bhagavad Gita became one with Krishna's desire. Fine. So in our life also, when we manage our desires and wishes to align them with the wish of God, then it brings all prosperity and victory. So if we have selfish desires separate from the Lord, then we will not get any prosperity and victory. But if our desires become one with the desires of Krishna, then we will get all prosperity and victory. So we don't have to suppress our desires. We have to align the desires with God's desires. And what is God's desire? He doesn't have any selfish desire. His desire is for our welfare only, right? So Krishna is our genuine well-wisher. So when we understand that Krishna is my genuine well-wisher, and whatever is his wish, I need to try to execute it by the power given by him only. So Bhagavad Gita ends with this note. We need to harmonize human will with divine will, and that will bring all success. Fine. So the ultimate victory is in aligning our will with Krishna's will. Self-centered success is neither satisfying nor sustainable. But success attained by selfless surrender to Krishna is satisfying and sustainable both. So Arjuna received that inner enlightenment, and outer attainment is success, right? Internally, he was enlightened by the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita. So externally, he is going to attain success in all his endeavors. So this is how Bhagavad Gita concluded. So yatra yogeshwaraha krishno yatra partho dhanurdharaha tatra shrir vijayo bhutir dhruva nitir matir mama. So wherever there is Krishna and wherever there is Arjuna, certainly there will be victory. So to summarize, to give a summary in one sentence, when we agree to act according to Krishna's desires, then we become successful. When we become independent and when we become indifferent to Krishna's instructions, we will not get any success or victory. So success and victory and prosperity are ensured for a devotee who aligns one's will with God's will. I hope this message is clear. So I'm very happy and very enlivened to have your association for 30 long days. One full month, every single day, we are meeting at 7:30 or 7:25 in the morning. Wherever I am, I was traveling this month a lot. So wherever I am, whatever state I am in, I am coming to take your loving association for this one full month. And it has helped me also a lot in meditating on the instructions of Bhagavad Gita. Especially so many children are participating more in this morning sessions. So seeing their nice recitations and their understanding and very nice questions, I'm also very much inspired. And if there are any discrepancies in the overall conduction of this 30-day course, so I beg forgiveness from all of you. And certainly, it's a very wonderful thing that we all have taken out our time, around 300 devotees. It began with some 500, 600 devotees. And anyways, by the end of the month, still there are 300 devotees still enthusiastically coming live to participate in this Gita recitations and meditating on Gita wisdom. So I'm very happy and grateful to all of you for your wonderful participation and helping me also to meditate on Gita wisdom. Thank you very much. So we'll conclude here. Srimad Bhagavad Gita ki jai, Srila Prabhupada ki jai. So when some devotees also wanted these sessions to continue for a long time, every day someone said, let's do it one full year, daily 2 shlokas, 700 shlokas in 1 year. And some said at least cover 100 important shlokas. But we also have to acknowledge the fact that devotees are very busy with their activities, and children are also busy with their school studies. So we are going to conduct this again in summer holidays for 1 month, and again winter holidays, winter time for 1 more month. So in 1 year we'll cover 108 shlokas. So details our devotees will post in the groups. You can be in touch. So and many devotees also had a lot of questions based on these 30 shlokas. So evening we'll meet again for a Q&A session. I'll speak a few minutes only, maybe 15-20 minutes I'll speak. So rest of the time all children can ask their questions. So we'll have a Q&A session based on these 30 shlokas today evening, IST. So thank you very much for your participation. If anyone would like to recite more shlokas, you're welcome. Yes, your Madhav Priya, Shyam Kundas. You can recite. Unmute yourself.
I forgot to rename myself.
Okay.
Yeah, can I recite this shloka which you just?
Yes, you can recite.
यत्र योगेश्वर कृष्ण यत्र पार्थो धनुर्धर तत्र श्री विजयो भूतिर् ध्रुव नीतिर्मतिर् मम
हरि कृष्ण
थैंक यू प्रभुजी थैंक यू फॉर ऑल 30 डेज क्लास आई कुडंट अटेंड ऑल बट आई ट्राइड टू लिसन टू द रिकॉर्डिंग
हरि कृष्ण प्रभुजी कैन आई रिसेट
यस प्लीज
यत्र योगेश्वर कृष्ण यत्र पार्थादनोदर तत्र श्री विजय भूतर ध्रुवनिधिमतिर्मम हरे कृष्ण प्रभुजी थैंक यू फॉर दिस वंडरफुल एसोसिएशन एंड कैन यू प्लीज
नो सॉरी आई कांट हियर यू
हां
very nice classes. The meaning was explained very like easily and with many examples, and I want to recite this shloka. यत्र योगीश्वर कृष्णो यत्र पार्थो धनुर्धर तत्र श्री विजयो भूते ध्रुवनीतिर्मतिर्मम
थैंक यू सो मच गायत्री गायत्री
यत्र योगेश्वर कृष्ण यत्र पार्थो धनुर्धर यत्र श्री विजयो भूते
यत्र योगेश्वर कृष्ण यत्र पार्थो धनुर्धर तत्र श्री विजयो भूतेर् ध्रुवनीतिर्मतिर्मम हरे कृष्ण प्रभुजी थैंक यू फॉर द क्लास
थैंक यू अन्विता